the Gurudeva online class. My dear friends, this is the second part video from the second lesson, that is decimal. Okay, in this video you are going to learn how to convert the decimal fractions into common fractions and common fractions into decimal fractions, both vice versa. Okay, so in the exercise 2.2 AMA, the question is convert the following into decimal fractions. Okay, here we need to convert the fractions into decimal fractions. We already know what is the meaning of fractions and decimal fractions. Fractions having the number numerator and denominator, but the decimal fraction having the point, the number along with the decimal point, that is decimal fraction. Okay, here the first in the AMA we need to convert the fractions into decimal fractions. How to convert? Okay, so here there are three subtopics, that is fractions with the denominator 10, fractions with the denominator 100, and last one is fraction with the denominator 1000. See how to convert. The first I will show the 1000, 10, and also one more 100 also. The first, in the first question, 634 divided by 1000. So in the denominator place there will be 1000, means how many zeros are there here? There are 3 zeros, 1, 2, 3. Afterwards, we need to write the numerator value, that is 634. Okay, so after writing this, where we need to keep the decimal point? Means here, how many digits are there? There are 3 digits, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so from the right side, we need to count 3 places, 1, 2, 3. After 3 places, we need to keep the decimal point. Okay, so we can write 000.634, or else we can write 0.634. Both are also right. Okay, so this is a way to convert the fractions into decimal fraction. One more. Okay, but here the denominator is only having the 10. So how to write here? How many zeros are there? Only 10. So write 10. After in the numerator place there will be 800. So write here 800. Where we need to keep the point? Here how many zeros are there? Only 10. So I written here 0. Afterwards I written the numerator value here. Okay. The next step is, how many digits are there in the numerator? There are 3 digits, 800. Okay, after 3 digits, we need to keep the decimal point, 1, 2, 3. So, we need to keep the decimal point here. We can read 80.0 also, or 80.0. Okay, we can write like this also. Both are right. And third, here, having the value 8341 in the numerator and 1000 in the denominator. What is the first step? We need to write the zeros here. 1, 2, 3 zeros. Next, the numerator value 8341. Afterwards, count how many digits are there in the numerator. There are 4 digits. 8341. So 4 digits. After 4 digits, 1, 2, 3, 4 digits, we need to keep the decimal point here. Okay, so we can read 8.341, or else 0008.341. Both are also same. Okay, when we are reading 8.341. After decimal point, we need to read separate. Okay, and the next fourth question, 5/1000. Here also see, we need to write the zeros. 3 zeros are there, 3 zeros, and the numerator value 5. After writing this, how many digits are there in the numerator? Only 1 digit. So after 1 digit, we need to keep the decimal point, 0.005. Okay, I hope you understood how to convert the fractions into decimal fractions. The next main, that is B main, here opposite of the A main, means the questions are given in the decimal fractions, we need to convert into common fractions. Okay, how to convert? So here the first question is 39.586. So in the first question, check where is the decimal point. Okay, 39.586. After two values, okay, after two places, there is having a decimal point. Okay, so in the AMA, we know already here how many zeros are there. First we return, next numerator value, then we are counting the numerator places, how many digits are there, 1, 2, 3. So after 3 digits, we are keeping the decimal point. Here what we need to do, we need to do opposite, means here how many digits are there after the decimal point, there are 3 digits. 1, 2, 3. These are the 3 digits. So, we need to write 3 zeros with 1, means 1000 in the denominator. What about numerator? Numerator, we need to write the same number without decimal point, means 39,586. Okay, so this is the common fraction. Question are in the decimal fraction, we convert it into common fraction. Whether the answer is right or not, how to cross check? So here what is the first step? Convert the common fraction into decimal fraction. We need to write the zeros, 1, 2, 3. There are 3 zeros are there. So afterwards numerator 39586. Next we need to count the numerator places, how many digits are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After 5, we need to keep the decimal point. Okay, what we got here, 39.586. In the question, what is there, 39.586. Okay, so this is the right answer. And I will show one more problem, second problem. Okay, 7.080. The first step is we need to write the denominator value. How to write the denominator? Here, after decimal point, there are 3 digits. Okay, so 3 zeros with 1. In the numerator, as it is same, 7080. Okay, the 7080 divided by 1000 is the common fraction for 7.080. Third question, 497.15. So in the denominator, how many zeros we should write? There are only 2 zeros. Why? Because after the decimal point, there are only 2 values, 1 and 5. So we need to write 2 zeros with 1. And in the numerator, we need to write the same, 49715. Okay. And the last question, that is 0.008. In the denominator, here there are 3 values. After the decimal point, there are 3 values, 008. So write here 3 zeros with 1. In the numerator, we can write 008 or we can write 8 by 1000. So I hope you understood the A main and B main, how to convert the common fractions into decimal fraction and decimal fractions into common fractions. When the fractions having the denominator 10, 100 and 1000 only. Okay. After completion of the B main from the exercise 2.2, let us move on the C main. Okay, what is the C main question here? Write the fractional and decimal expansion of the following. Means we need to write the given number in the expanded form, means the given in the decimal fraction, the decimal fractions we need to write in the expanded form. How to write? Okay, so we know already the place value chart. The 6 it is in the 1's place and 1 it is in the 10's place. Okay, so I will write the place value chart first. 10's, 1's, afterwards decimal point, next 10th, next 100th, and next is 1000. Okay, this is the place value chart we know already. Suppose here there is another extra number means again 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, like that. Okay, but here there is only two values, that is ones and tens. So the 6 it is in the ones place and 1 it is in the tens place. After, okay, there is a decimal point. Next, 8 is in the tenth place. How we can write the 8 means 8 by 10. Tenth place we are writing 8 by 10. 8 means here there is the given number. Next, in the 100th place, 0 means 0 by 100. Next, 7 it is in the 1000. So, 7 by 1000. So, like that we can expand it. So, afterwards, after knowing how to expand the given number, how to write, okay, the 1 tens means 10 plus 6 it is in the 1 space means 6 plus 8 by 10 plus 0 by 100 plus 7 by 1000. Okay, so this is the expanded form of 16.807 decimal fraction. Okay, so I hope you know how to write the given decimal fractions into expanded form. I will show another two problems from the exercise 2.2 CMA. The second question is 475.863. Okay, the 5 it is in the 1's place, 7 it is in the 10's place and 4 it is in the 100 place. Okay, next afterwards decimal point, next 8 is in the 10th place, 6 it is in the 100th place, 3 it is in the 1000th place. Okay, so how we can write? So in the 1's place 5, 10's place 7, 100th place 4, decimal point. Next 8 it is in the 10th place, 6 it is in the 100th place, next 3 it is in the 1000th place. Okay, here there is no 1th place. Okay, after decimal point, directly 10th, 100th, 1000th. Okay, see how we can write. The 4 is in the 100th place, means 400. Okay, plus 7 is in the 10th place, means 70. Plus 5 is in the 1th place, 5. Plus 8 is, it is in the 10th place, means 8 by 100. So, 8 by 10 plus 6 it is in the 100th place, 6 by 100 plus 3 it is in the 1000th place, so 3 by 1000. So this is a way to write the given decimal fractions into expanded form. Okay, I will show one more problem, that is third question, 0.047. Okay, so in the 1's place there will be 0, afterwards decimal point, next in the 10th place, okay, 0, and 100th place 4, and 1000th place 7. Okay, so how to write in the expanded form? It is in the 1's place, so 0 plus 0 it is in the 10th place, 0 by 10 plus 4 is in the 100th place, 4 by 100 plus 7 is in the 1000th place, so 7 by 1000. So this is the expanded form for given question, that is 0.047 decimal fraction. Okay, so remaining one problem you will try to solve in your book. Okay, if you got any doubt regarding how to write in the expanded form, you can ask me doubts in the live interaction class. Next, let us move on the last main from the exercise 2.2, that is D main. So in the D main, we need to write the given fractions into short form. Okay, the first question, 5 by 10th and 8 by 100th. Okay, that is in the fraction, we need to write in the short form. How to write in the short form? So we know already the place value chart, that is 100, 10, 1's decimal point and 10th ओके हंड्रेड, नेक्स्ट इज थाउजेंड. ओके वी नो ऑलरेडी दिस इज द प्लेस वर यू चैट. द 5 by 10 मीन्स द 5 by 10 इट इज कम्स अंडर द 10th प्लेस. ओके आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट 5 by 10 एंड द 8 by 100 दट इज कम अंडर द 100th प्लेस दट इज 8 by 100. ओके हाउ टू राइट इन द शॉर्ट फॉर्म मीन्स इन द 1th प्लेस 10th प्लेस 100th प्लेस देर इज नो वैल्यू मीन्स 0 point. Here 10th place what is the value? 5 and 100th place what is the value? 8. So write 8. 0.58 is the short form for 5 by 10 plus 8 by 100. This is the way to convert the given fractions into short form. I will show one more problem, that is second problem. 7 by 10 means the 7 it is in the 10th place. Okay, so I will write here the 7 by 10th. Next 0 by 100, in the 100th place there is a 0. Next in the 1000th 8, so 1000th place 8 by 1000. Okay, so after decimal point, right? In the before there is no values here, okay, so 0. After decimal point there will be 7, next 0, next 8. 0.708 is the short form for a given decimal fractions, given fractions. Okay, so I will show one more, that is third question. 2 ones plus 3 tenths. Okay, so here they gave in the ones place 2. Okay, in the ones place we know 2. Afterwards there is a decimal point. Decimal point in the 10th place 3 means here. Okay, 2.3. There is no 100th, 1000th, 0, 0. Only they gave 2 ones plus 3 tenths. 2.3. Okay, suppose instead of 3 tenths, again they extended plus 400, means we should write here after 3, 4. Why? Because in the 100th place there will be 4, so write 4, 2.34. but in the question they gave only 2 ones plus 3 tenths, so 2.3 is the short form. And the fourth question is 3 ones plus 4 tenths plus 600. Okay, so in the ones place write 3. Afterwards there is a decimal point, write decimal point. Next 4 tenths, in the tenths place write 4, and next is 100th place having a 6. So 3.46 is the short form for a given numbers. Okay, so I hope you understood the 2.2 exercise all problems. So after completion of the converting the common fractions into decimal fractions and decimal fractions into common fractions, let us move on the next topic, that is like decimal and unlike decimal. What is the meaning of like decimal and unlike decimal? Okay, so like decimals means the decimal having the same decimal points, that is called like decimals. Example for like decimals is, okay, 0.7, 7.1, 7.3, 4.5. Here after the decimal point, okay, all numbers having only the 10th place, Okay, here 7, 1, 3, 5. Means only the single places, that is 10th places, that is called like decimal. And also 0.72, 1.72, 8.35, 4.67, any value, but the places should be the same. Here also 10th place and 100th place, 10th place, 100th place, 10th place, 100th place, 10th place, 100th place. Okay, so all the values have the same place value. So this is called like decimal. What is the meaning of unlike decimal? Unlike decimals means, okay, the decimals having the different values. Suppose, okay, 0.7, 7.71, 8.17, 8.717, okay, etc. Now look at after the decimal points having the different places for different, here having only the 10th place, here 10th place plus 100th place, here 10th place, 100th place, here 10th, 100th and 1000th place. Okay, in one question having the different places, so it is called unlike decimals. Here all the decimals value having the same decimal place values, so it is called like decimals. Okay, 10th, 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 10th. Okay, you don't compare the numbers, just you compare the places. Okay, so this is the difference between the like decimals and unlike decimals. Suppose how to convert the unlike decimals into like decimals. Okay, so same example I will take this 0.7, 7.71, 8.17, 8.717. This is the unlike decimal. How to convert unlike decimals into like decimal? Okay, so here the 0.7 having only the 10th place. Here 7.71 having the 10th place plus 100th place. And the next 8.17 having the 10th place plus 100th place. Next, the last value, that is 8.717 having 10th place, 100th place and also 1000th place. So what we need to do here, write 0.7, here how many digits are there? 3 digits. So after writing the digit, we need to write the 0. Okay, 10th, 100th, 1000th. Next is 7.71. Still we need one more digit, that is we can add 0. Okay, and next 8.17. Here also we need one more place, that is 0, 1000th place. Next here 8.717. Now look at all the values having the same place values, that is 10th, 100th, 1000th. 10th, 100th, 1000th. Here 10th, 100th, 1000th. 10th, 100th, 1000th. So this is called like decimal. Okay, my dear students, I hope you understood how to convert the unlike decimals into like decimals. After knowing how to convert the unlike decimal into like decimals, okay, let us move on the next topic, that is comparisons of the numbers. Okay, I will show the few examples from the exercise 2.3 AMA. By this, I will explain the how to compare the two numbers. Okay, so let us take the first problem from the exercise 2.3 AMA. Here, the question is 0.1347-0.3147. Here, my dear students, the first step is we need to check the integral part or whole number, means the decimal point left side. Okay, the decimal point left side, here there will be 0 and here also there will be 0. So the two numbers also having the same number, the two parts also having the same number. So next step is after the decimal point we need to check whether the numbers having the same or not. Okay, here 1 is there, here 3 is there. Okay, so compare the 1 and 3, 3 is the greater number. So 0.3147 is the greatest number compared to the 0.1347. Okay, first step is we need to check the integral part, means this part we need to check. Okay, suppose those two parts also having the same number, next step is the after the decimal point we need to check. Suppose the again in the 10th place having the same number, then we need to check the next place, that is 100th place value. Again it is same, next we need to move on the next place, that is 1000th place. Like that we need to cross check the two parts also. Okay, and second question, 86.13-86.30. Here the integral parts are the same, 86 and 86. After the decimal point having the 1 but here 3. So compare 1 and 3, 3 is the greater number. So we need to keep this mark, greatest mark. Okay. So the third one, 0.239 and another part 0.237. Okay, the first step is to check the integral part. Here also having the 0, here also having the 0. So after the decimal point 2, same. Next 3, here also 3. Next here in the 1000th place 9 and here 7. Compare the 7 and 9, 9 is the greatest number. So we need to keep this mark. Okay, so remaining 3 problems you try to solve in your textbook. So after knowing how to compare the two parts or two numbers, okay, let us move on the next main, that is B main. Here the question is, write the following in ascending and descending order. Okay, ascending means we already know the smallest number to the biggest number, and descending order means biggest number to the smallest number. So here they give the four values, we need to write in the ascending order and descending order. The first is ascending order. Out of these four, which is the very smallest number, let us check. 0.75, 0.759, 0.573, 0.467. These four values also having the 0 in the integral part. Okay, after the decimal point, let us check. Here 7, 7, 5, 4. So out of these, 4 is the smallest number. Okay, so this is smallest. Write first 0.467. Okay, this is the smallest value. Afterwards, compare in these three values. Okay, after the decimal point, 7, here also 7, next 5. Okay, 7, 7, 5. Out of these, the 5 is the smallest number. So write 0.573. Okay, and the next, remaining only these two, 0.75, 0.75. Okay, after the decimal point having the 7575, but here 9 is there, here there is no digit, means it is 0. Okay, this is the biggest number, this is the smallest number. So write the smallest value, that is 0.75. Next 0.759. Okay, so this is the ascending order. Descending order, reverse of the ascending order. Okay, so write 0.759, 0.75, 0.573 and 0.467. Okay, this is the descending order. I will show one more problem from the B main, that is second question. 69.76, 96.067, 69.67, 96.73. Out of these four, which is the smallest number? Okay, compare in the integral part, 69, 96, 6. So compare the 6 greatest number. So the 6 is the smallest number. Write 69.67 is the smallest, the first 69.67. Okay, afterwards 69.76. Okay, ascending means we need to write the smallest to the greatest number. After 96.067 and 96.73, out of these two, which is the smallest number? 96, 96, having both same. Next, after the decimal point, the 0 having, but here 7. Okay, the 0 is the smallest number compared to the 7. So write 96.067. At last 96.73. This is the biggest number out of these four. Okay. After completion of the ascending order, descending order is to write the reverse of the ascending order. Okay. 96.73 and 96.067, 69.76, next 16.67. Okay, this is the descending order. So, my dear students, I hope you understood the exercise 2.2 as well as 2.3 in this video. Suppose if you got any doubt regarding these problems, you can ask me in the live interaction class. Thank you.